Hi, I'm Di Huizer from PLR Planners, and in this video I'm going to show you how to create scrapbook papers in book format for Amazon KDP. Now, bearing in mind that the biggest size that Amazon can print for square papers is 8x8, and traditionally scrapbook paper is 12x12, I figured it was worth a shot trying to see whether these products would sell in an 8x8 format. Now, bearing in mind that the paper type from Amazon is 100 grams when you're doing a full color print. So it is not traditional scrapbooking paper, which is acid free and 12 by 12 size. So I figured it was still worth a shot, and I'm going to show you how I put this together and then show you what my results have been to date. So we're going to create a PowerPoint file with bleed, and then I'm going to put my page graphics in there, and I'm going to show you three ways of doing it. One is manually. The second way is using my PowerPoint replicator, and the third way is using Hunter's new Easy Journal. All right, so let's start by just getting rid of that. And the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to set up a new slide, and I'm going to go into design, and I'm going to go into slide size, and we're going to go to custom slide size. Now, because we are going full color and we want the patterns to go right to the edge of the page, we need to create this document with bleed. So we are going to make it 8.1.25 inches in width and 8.25 inches in height, and that will give us our bleed. So now the document is ready. Now all you need to do is open up a subdirectory that's got your images in. Now I have a whole ton of paper packs that I've created, so let's go and pick one that we can play with. So we've got neutral navy. Let's try. So there I've got a whole lot of patterns, and I'm not going to use all of them because, bearing in mind, this is a full color print book. So the maximum number of images I'm going to put in is 21 or 22, and I'm going to be doing them back to back. So the same pattern will appear on the right hand side and the left hand side so that people can use it any way they want. So I'm just simply going to pick up the first one and drag it into my PowerPoint file. So move that out the way. We'll drag that in there. Okay, and then I'm going to go in for a new slide. And I'm just going to duplicate that one because that's going to be the right-hand page. This is going to be the left-hand page, and we want them to be the same. So for the next one, I'll just simply drag in the next image and then copy it, duplicate the slide, put in a new slide, and all the way through until I'm finished with the document, and it's really that simple. All right, let me show you another way of doing it. I'm going to use my PowerPoint replicator to quickly create the file for me. So I'm going to go into insert, a shape, I'm going to select a square, and I'm going to make it fit the whole thing. And then I'm going to set this one up as image one. And then I'm going to duplicate the slide, and I'm going to make this image 02. Okay, so now my file is ready, and I'm simply just going to save this, and then I'm going to run my replicator. So here's my Excel spreadsheet that I'm going to be using for the replicator, and I'm simply going to go and pick up my graphics. And I'll just kick up the first 40, so up to there, and then Control Shift A. Here's path. Pop it in there, and now I'll just simply save this and run my replicator. So now I'll select my PowerPoint file. So now I'll select my data file, and then I'll verify it. And then all that's doing is checking that my PowerPoint file and my Excel file have the same field names. And now what I'm going to do is click on replicate. And there you have it. Okay, so now you can see that it's duplicated it all for me. And if I roll down, I've actually got 82 pages, which is too much. I should actually only have 40 pages here because I don't want to make it too expensive. So that'll give me 20 papers, so to speak, so that I can keep the selling price below $10. Okay. So that's how you create it that way. And then I'm going to quickly show you how to create it using Hunter's Easy Journal. So I'll close that down. All right, so now I have a blank template. So what I'm going to do now is just go to add-ins, and I'm going to go to Easy Journal. And I'm going to select my image files by clicking on that button. I'm going to insert a shape again, and this time I'm just going to edit it and say curly brackets, and I'm going to format that so we don't have any shape, fill, or color. So no fill and no outline. Okay, and you'll see somewhere here we've got the text. It's just now just showing us white. I'm just going to make that black. Okay, so there's my field name ready to go. So now all I need to do is, I'm not going to use a text file, I'm just simply going to use the images, so I'll click on go. It's done 20 slides. Now, of course, remembering that because we're going to be doing this as a book, this method has only brought one across each time. So what I would do now is I would just duplicate each of these slides all the way down to the bottom, and your book is basically ready. Now all you would do is save it as a PDF and then create your cover. All right. So when I started testing this product, the first one I loaded was this cherry denim papers, and it has sold 6 copies to date. I started it off with advertising, of which so 3 copies were sold by advertising, and I stopped the advertising after a week because I wanted to see what happened on its own. And then I uploaded elegance papers and I uploaded the retro style papers, and to date I've sold 1 of the elegance papers. So it's interesting to see that they are starting to sell. Some of the sales I know came from my Facebook group. So I'm going to keep on testing the advertising and see how that does over the next month or so. So if you've got any questions about this, let me know. I'm happy to talk about it in the group or via email.